let us find the side, the measure of these sides, which is marked as x. Okay, find the, for the triangles given below, find the value of x, correct to two decimal places. So these are the steps I would like you to follow when you are dealing with this type of examples. The first is to label the sides. So you got two sides to be labeled here. So first is to label the side which is the longest side. So this side is the longest side and the side opposite to the right angle. So I'll label that as h. H stands for hypotenuse. H stands for hypotenuse. Okay. And the side which is opposite to the angle, so let me label this as an by Greek letter called theta. So this is theta, which is the side, which is the angle. And this side is the opposite to the angle. And this is, I'll label that as O. O stands for opposite. O stands for opposite. So you're dealing with O and H. You're labeled O and H. So you've got three formulas to remember. You don't have to remember. So this is so. The sign so stands for, so H stands for this formula. Sine of the angle, sine theta, or sine of an angle, is O divided by H. Okay, and that's well known by drawing this triangle. Okay, this is called the triangle formula, a triangle rule. I'll call this SO. Okay, so here you're dealing with O and H, so we're using this formula. Okay, so let me put a smiley face for this formula. So this is the formula that we are using. So what does this formula tell me? This formula tells me O, which is sitting on the top, is this times this, that is sine of the angle times H. So O, which is sitting on the top and looking down at S and H, so O is telling S and H, you multiply and I'll, that will be my answer. So this is sine of the angle, sine theta times hypotenuse. Okay, so first write the formula down and then apply the formula. So I've decided the formula. This is the step of applying, drawing the triangle. And now we have to apply. So this is the application stage. And now I have to substitute. So what is O? O is X is equal to sine of the angle. Sine theta is the angle, which is 23 times 1. Now you do need a calculator which has these keys. Okay, so go to so first this is my scientific calculator, so I have to change this into degrees. Okay, so now I have to type in sine 23 times 1 which is 0.39. we want to round it to two decimal places, so the third decimal value is 0. So if the third decimal place is 5, 6, 7, 8, or 9, you increase the second decimal place by 1. Here, as it is 0, you don't increase or decrease. You leave the number as it is. So the answer would be 0.39. Excuse me, 0.39. And this is rounded to two decimal places. So this is your answer. That's it. Okay. The next example is, I want you to do it yourself. Okay, so this is, so I only label this. So this is your angle, which is theta. This is the opposite side, and this is your hypotenuse. So I would like you to do it yourself. Apply these, go through these steps, and you'll get the answer. Okay, so let me move on. Now for this triangle, this is the angle. So let me label, this is theta. This is your, the longest side, so that is H. And this is the angle side. This is the side with the angle. Okay, and that is A. A stands for angle side, or the side along with the angle. Okay, so this is the angle. This is the side along with the angle. So I'll call that A. In some books, they call it adjacent. So don't label this. Suppose by mistake you are labeling this. Okay, then cross it out. Okay, cross it out, because you're not dealing with this side. So dealing with this side and this side. So which formula has A and H? So well, car has A and H. So I'll draw the car triangle. I call this the triangle rule or the car triangle. So this is car. Now A is what you want to find. So A is sitting up and C and H are underneath A. So A tells, so A says that A tells that if you multiply yourself, that is C stands for cos of the angle theta times hypotenuse, which is I'll write H. Okay, so let me apply. So we have labeled, we have decided the formula, we have drawn the triangle, and this is the stage of applying the rule, whether to multiply or divide. In some cases, you may have to divide. So here A is your X is equal to cos 17 times H. What is H? H is 4. So get the calculator out. So that is cos 17 times 4, which is 3.825. So the third decimal place is 5. As I told you, if the third decimal place is 5, 6, 7, 8, or 9, you have to increase the second decimal place or value by 1. So you have to increase this by 1. So this will be 3.83. So x is 3.83. And you have to write the decimal, you're rounding. So this is rounded to 2 dp or 2 decimal places. Okay, the next question is something you can do again. So this is the angle. So think about this. But this is the hypotenuse. And what is this side? This is the adjacent side. So that is A. So I would like you to do it yourself, applying, going through these steps. Okay, the next question. So this is the angle. So let me label this angle. What is this side? This is the longest side, the side opposite to the right angle. That's not to be labeled because it's not given. So we are labeling the sides that are given. So this is, so think about this, this side, what is this side and what is this side? Okay, I hope you can remember. This is the side opposite to the angle, so that's opposite. And this is the side with the angle. This side is with the angle, so that's A. So which formula uses O and A? So well, that is TOA. So TOA is smiling at you. So use me, use me. So let me draw the TOA triangle. It's always good to draw the triangle or the rule of the triangle or the triangle rule. So this is TOA. Again, the same, O is sitting up. So O is T, T stands for tan of the angle times A. Okay, so what is O? O is X. X is tan of the angle. What's the angle? Angle is 35 times A. What? How much is A? A is 12. So this is label, decide, draw the triangle, and this is the step of applying the rule. So let's apply the rule. So this is 10. So let me delete it. 10, 35 times 12. 10, 35 times 12 is 8.402. So 2 is less than 5. And as you're rounding to 2 decimal places, you have to write this 0. So x is 8.40. And this is rounded to 2 decimal places. Okay, let us look at the next question. Okay, so here you have, where's the next question? Okay, so I'll draw a triangle. I would like you to draw, use, so this is the next question. So this is the angle. So let me say this is a 60 degrees, not drawn to scale. This is your X and this is your 18 centimeters. Okay, so I would like you to do this yourself, going through these steps. Okay, so this is the next example. Okay, I would like you to do this yourself, and I got few more examples here. So there's one more example here. So decide the sides and angle, apply this formula and do the rest.